And I'm like, don't do this to me. Like, I've dealt with things. I don't want to go back, you know.
Yeah.
But for, I did go back to a lot of things, but I've healed.
For me, I've always been someone who doesn't really fit in, you know, and not for not wanting to. I mean, I have an accent. I'm not white with an accent. I'm very brown with an accent. I'm not a newcomer.
There's a lot of calm there. We're very much in touch, Rak and I. In fact, he just messaged me this morning because he wanted to wish my nephew happy birthday. So, you know,
the strongest ladies have come together for a story which needs to be told, which needs to be watched. I'm talking about Riddhi Dogra and Monica Dogra. Thank you, both of you. They are all with me today on Bollywood Bubble. Thank you again.
Thank you. Thank you.
Firstly, I have to tell you that the trailer looks amazing. When I watched it, I thought this is a story which needs to be told. I believe that it will stir a conversation which will be great, and I hope that happens. But firstly, tell me, to start on a very lighter note, how was it to tell the story on set? How was it to be performing together? Because you're coming together for the first time, right?
Right. We'd met earlier. We did a little chat show where mm-hmm. you were hosting, or she was hosting, and I was the guest, and it was a lot of fun. I think I was comfortable with her from the start. She was, and then we did a promo shoot, and we were just like talking about things only we could understand and no one else. I was like, this is going to be good. We're going to have a lot of fun on set, and that's exactly how it was. It was very easy to work with her. I got her. You know, as a performer, you go through a certain gamut of emotions, and she did. And I feel like I always got you, like I did. And it was very easy. Our working together was very, very easy. It came naturally.
Yeah. So I think cool. The working together part was very easy, but the show itself demanded a lot. And Riddhi is a very fine actor. It was an honor and a pleasure to work with her. And I've already, like, whatever I've seen, I've been blown away. So the show took so much out of us that if we didn't have each other's backs, I don't know how I would have.
I can imagine, because when we see the trailer, there's a roller coaster of emotion that we also go through, right? Where I feel the expression changes after every second, because you're like, oh, this is fine. Oh, okay.
In one scene, I'm like, my joke about one scene, it's like, one scene.
Yeah.
Just it was a 2-minute scene.
But did it, like you mentioned, you know, that the roller coaster of emotion, also because Asta, like you mentioned, is someone whose life from the surface looks like it's the best life you could have. You have everything. You're the best daughter, you're the best wife, you're everything that a woman is expected to be, but somewhere you're void. You see, you are empty inside, right? As women, I think all of us at some point feel that, because we are just trying each day to be the perfect daughter, to be the perfect you know, woman in the house, to be that perfect person who is setting an example or leading by an example. And somewhere we lose ourselves during that process. Personally, if I have to ask, did you ever, it's even redundant to say that you never did, but did you have to tap on those feelings to be able to portray or to bring Asta, or to give a certain nuance to Asta as well?
For sure. I mean, you do bring your experiences, and like I said, all the tears are real, you know, like most of the times, you know, Sahir would say, our director would say that, you know, I want you to cry here. And he would give me time. He would give me 10, 15 minutes, and he would start psyching me. He's like, go back to this here. And I'm like, don't do this to me. Like, I've dealt with things. I don't want to go back, you know.
Yeah.
But for, I did go back to a lot of things, but I've healed. I've healed from so much. But I'm sure, I mean, obviously, your healing journey never stops. Yeah. My God, this sounded like a very philosophical.
No, but it's the fact. It is the fact of life. I'm sure people will watch, they'll also relate to it, because all of us are going through that process simultaneously.
But there are times when, you know, one has been lost and confused, and you feel like you're not visible, like you're not. I have felt what Asta feels, and I've also applied a lot of what I've seen around me. You know, I observe women, I observe people, and I was just constantly keeping that in mind. And generally what women have, and it was a different time. It was a very different time than what it is today for women. Even though our struggles are the same, but yeah, I did tap into things and it did help.
Mm. And that's the thing that's so interesting, is even though it was a different time, somehow everything is so relevant to today. Yeah. Everything.
It's just the way how it made to feel. Perhaps that has changed, but the feeling is still the same.
Yeah, I mean, yeah. I'd say the exact same. So one of the things that's spoken about a lot is the stereotype of Pipalika versus the stereotype of Asta. And I think despite the stereotype of Asta, you'd say Monica Dogra couldn't relate, but I can relate completely. Sometimes I think any woman can relate, maybe not just women, maybe men too. We all can relate to what it means to play roles in our lives,
right,
and somewhere feel like we need to disrupt that momentum and choose ourselves. And that's very scary, because it means, and all of the things that I am, like I'm a musician, I'm a DJ, I'm an actor, I'm a daughter, I'm a sister, I can say in all of those roles I've played, I've disappointed them by choosing myself at various times and various stages.
Yeah, but tell me, also when we say that choosing yourself comes with its own pros and cons, like a lot of pros for us because we finally get to be what we want to be, right? But that also means, especially in a society which usually demands a lot from women, I'm sorry, I know they demand from men as well, but I will specifically speak about women because somewhere I have been in that shoes as well, so you relate to it all the more, right? How difficult is it to choose yourself when everyone else is perhaps demanding that, no, you have to be this, you have to be that, but then suddenly you just feel, why can't I just be me? Even if for an hour, maybe 5 minutes, but why can't?
Well, I think the big difference is, just to jump in, the big difference is, yes, choosing yourself is difficult, maybe for everyone, men, women alike, but we're not taught to. I think that's the difference. I feel like men are taught to, and women aren't. Like, from
there's a stigma attached to when a woman chooses.
My earliest memories from childhood was that I was groomed to be a wife. I was taught that my ability to partner next to a man somehow indicated my worth, which then taught me how to be something other than who I was to make sure I was desirable. Like the pressures of appearance, the pressures of, it's like women need to be successful in the workplace, amazing in the kitchen, like beautiful, fit, like we have to be all the things in order to be wanted by someone else. Not wanted by ourselves, but wanted by someone else. Undoing that when that's how you're groomed. And I think there's a universality to that. I know most of my friends, no matter how radical, liberal, or woke they might be, we all experience that. Yeah. Undoing that is really hard. So then you feel guilty when you choose yourself. That's the problem.
Yeah, I think you do. I mean, if you decide to live a life of your own, and if you decide that, no, this is what works for me, even if it's just like, not going for a family function, it starts like that, right?
Yeah.
That's how tiny it is.
Yeah.
Because,
yeah.
I mean, you know, it's very strange. Even I remember as a kid, and I think these were small things that actually changed things for me. If there was a family function at home, it was fine if my brother said no. He wasn't even asked, but I was expected to go. Yeah. You're going to wear this. And you went with it, you know, you went with it till you grew up, and then I questioned everybody.
And then did you dance there and sing there also?
Yeah, but that was my choice.
Right.
But I was like, wait a minute, now I've, you know, like then there came a point where I grew up and I was like, I don't want to go for these things. But yeah, you do have to stand up for yourself because we're not taught to.
Yeah.
And I think things are changing majorly now. I mean, everywhere the conversations are different. The fact that we are talking about this in a way that we understand what we're saying, what you're, you know, asking.
Mm.
It's great. Yeah. It's great. And but yeah, I have gone through that entire struggle of choosing myself over everything and everyone else, because that's where your true happiness lies.
But tell me, now coming to the married woman, also focuses on a subject which is usually something which people, you know, shy away from talking about. Or we have seen ministers, we have seen many influential people call homosexuality as disease, as you know, various things. I don't even want to say it because it's just so absurd and it would mean that I'm giving attention to those things. But we have seen the absurdest things being said about someone's sexuality. Here we are, finally, there's a show which is talking about embracing it, finding it within yourself and being happy about it, irrespective of what people say. But I also know that comes with a lot of judgment from within the society, Vithi and Monica. Was it a difficult choice that was offered to you? Or did you even for once think that how will this be taken by the audiences? Because I know a lot of people just jumped to conclusions.
I actually, as a person, don't care about what people think and say. So
your body of work has been...
I do my own thing. I do me, boo. So I didn't think twice. I did have this apprehension, which I would probably have for anything, you know. It's such an intimate show. It's got a beautiful thought. The story has a beautiful thought to it, and what it's trying to what it's trying to say. So I just wanted that the team handles it with sensitivity and grace.
I didn't either. I feel like my body of work has been, yeah, from music to film, I don't want to call them controversial choices, but I take chances. You know, I take a lot of chances. Yeah, and this was so in line with what... In fact, when you hear, you know, do you want to be in this serial or this TV show, you think, I don't know, you know? And then I read the script and I met the writers and I was like, yes, you know? So I had once I saw what the story was, and then I was even more excited when I saw it was Vithi.
And that's one of the reasons why I'm looking forward to it, because very rarely people do this, you know, to handle a subject which really needs that kind of a sensitivity, because it might offend a lot of people if not portrayed in a way it deserves to be, right? But like she said, now filmmakers, writers are taking chances, especially with the OTT, with actors as well as the script. It's a great change for both of them, right? Rithi, personally, because I know that the body of work that you have done, it's always been strong women, opinionated women, right? Then beech mein aapne kaafi sabbatical bhi le liya, because you said that you weren't getting the kind of roles you were looking for. Finally, do you think you have come to a point where writing is getting better, where defined roles are being given to women, where you can actually say that, oh, this is something I'm excited about?
I know that OTT has opened up that space. You know, we earlier just had theatre, television, films.
Yeah.
And all the three were very, very strictly defined. You know, mm-hmm. There was you're a theatre actor, you're a TV actor, you're a film actor. I don't think that's true anymore.
Hmm.
Because I'll tell you why. I mean, of course, people still give those labels,
yes,
and but people have been giving labels forever.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
You know, labels will never go away. You
married woman in itself is a label.
Yeah. See, mm-hmm, it from a very...
Exactly.
You know.
But I feel like we as individuals and human, like, I absolutely negate all the labels. You can't put me in any label. You're calling me from a label, I'm not answering, you know. Someone says, oh, you were a television actor, now you're doing this. I'm like, no, I'm an actor. Mediums, yeah, there are mediums. And you put me in any, I've done theatre, I've done all kinds of work. So you put me in any medium, I'll perform. That's my job. My job is to add value to what you give me. My job is to, you know, make your writing better, elevate it. And take a chance on me. So I do feel like this was a chance, and I think those chances are only coming through because of OTT as a space, you know.
Yeah.
Because in a very commercial sense, it's not like a blink and you miss,
yeah,
it, you know.
Yeah.
It's not like a short film you did here or, yeah, a music video you did
which
there,
doesn't reach,
which doesn't really last.
Much, yeah.
But this is out there for consumption forever, and
yeah,
that definitely has come through with OTT.
I am also happy that it's finally giving chance to actors who definitely deserve those chances and were perhaps looking out for it.
Yes.
But mil nahi raha tha. Waise mil nahi raha tha. Mil gaya finally. But Monica, what about you? Do you also see a change in the way things are being written, the way things are being portrayed today?
Yeah, 100%. With all due respect to everything that's happened before, that raised me also. And the people who played strong roles and the women and the films that have been made in the past. I definitely see a freedom in the storytelling now. You know, like, there's a again, back to taking chances, not only taking chances with casting, but taking chances in the storytelling. Also with OTT, I think writers, directors, producers, now have actors like myself, I can actually go somewhere now and feel like I have a space. Whereas before, for me, I've always been someone who doesn't really fit in, you know, and not for not wanting to. I mean, I have an accent. I'm not white with an accent. I'm very brown with an accent. I'm not a newcomer. You know, I've done a lot of art films that have been critically successful, but not successful in the box office. So in the market of Bollywood, yeah. People are like, she's yeah. great, but where do we, you know, what, yeah. where do we put her? So this for me was like a dream come true, yeah, you know?
कितनी बार सुन लिया ये सारी
चीज़
टॉकिंग अबाउट इमैंसिपेशन ऑफ अ वुमन फ्रॉम अ पॉइंट वेयर शी हैज हिट द लो वेयर शी फील्स दैट शी इज लॉस्ट एंड शी इज देयर इज जस्ट नो वेयर टू गो राइट प्रीति आस्किंग यू फ्रॉम अ पर्सनल पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू हियर यू कैन चूज नॉट टू आंसर लाइक दिस यू हैव रिसेंटली फ्यू 2 years बैक आई वुड सपोज यू वर इन द सेम प्लेस वेयर आई थिंक यू वर जस्ट like a lot of questions were being raised on why. I remember I was also one of them because I was like, how did this divorce or how did this relationship fall apart? Because everything seemed very nice at that moment. But I also know that, you know, there must be a reason. There has to be something. And she has finally chosen herself. At that, I would call that was a turning point in a lot of ways for you as well. But you have moved on gracefully so in a very dignified way today. How does that relationship stand today and how much do that hurt or that point, you know, how much did you tap into to be able to do ask that?
Of course you tap into your life experiences and, you know, whatever you go through, but I've healed. I don't carry anything. I mean, there's a lot of calm there. We are very much in touch, Raak and I. In fact, he just messaged me this morning because he wanted to wish my nephew happy birthday. So, you know, there's no similarity between Aastha and me. Her world is very different than mine. But yes, you do tap into your life experiences like, you know, she mm-hmm. did and all actors do. Sometimes you elevate what, okay, I felt this and now this is what Aastha is feeling. But her journey has been her journey.
But if I may just ask you, did you ever face judgments because of that? Because a lot of times the woman is questioned more than the man. Sadly so, but that is how it is. Did you ever face that?
I'll tell you a very interesting thing. Mm-hmm. I really didn't face judgment because I don't take judgment. I don't care what you have to say. I saw how judgmental people were. Honestly, that's what I saw. When you were judging me, I didn't take any of the judgments. But I did see a pattern in our society. I saw a pattern of conditioning. I don't blame people. I actually sat back and I was like, wow, we're screwed. Everybody's screwed. They have no idea, you know. And so I really feel that is what I saw more. But like I told you, I don't care what people say. I've never cared. So yeah, I didn't really take anything. Because I was... Whatever you do in life, whatever you do, people will have judgments.
True.
So I was like, something is going to come. Some judgment is going to come from somewhere.
But I'm happy that you're healing and the process is still on. But thank you. Thank you, both of you.
Thank
you. The show is going to be amazing and looking forward.
Thank you so thank much. You. It was lovely talking to you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I'm Monica Dobra.
I'm Riti Dobra. So if you like the interview, please like, share and subscribe to
Bollywood Bubble.